A Beautiful Young Nymph Going to Bed by Jonathan Swift. Corinna, pride of Drury Lane, for whom no shepherd sighs in vain, never did Covent Garden boast so bright a battered strolling toast, no drunken rake to pick her up, no cellar ware on take to sup, returning at the midnight hour, four stories climbing to her bower, then, seated on a three-legged chair, takes off her artificial hair. Now, picking out a crystal eye, she wipes it clean and lays it by. Her eyebrows from a mouse's hide, stuck on with art on either side, pulls off with care, and first displays 'em, then in a playbook smoothly lays 'em. Now dexterously, her plumper's drawers that serve to fill her hollow jaws, untwists a wire, and from her gums a set of teeth completely comes. Pulls out the rags contrived to prop her flabby dugs, and down they drop. Proceeding on, the lovely goddess unlaces next her steel-ribbed bodice, which by the operator's skill press down the lumps, the hollows fill. Up goes her hand, and off she slips the bolsters that supply her hips. With gentlest touch, she next explores her chancres, issues, running sores, effects of many a sad disaster, and then to each applies a plaster. She must, before she goes to bed, rub off the daubs of white and red that smooth the furrows in her front, with greasy paper stuck upon't. She takes a bolus ere she sleeps, and then between two blankets creeps. With pains of love, tormented lies, or if she chance to close her eyes, of Bridewell and the Compter dreams, and feels the lash, and faintly screams. Or by a faithless bully drawn, at some hedge tavern lies in pawn. Or to Jamaica seems transported, alone and by no planter courted. Or near Fleet Ditch's oozy brinks, surrounded by a hundred stinks. Belated, seems on watch to lie, and snap some cully passing by. Or struck with fear, her fancy runs on watchmen, constables, and duns, from whom she meets with frequent rubs, but never from religious clubs, whose favour she is sure to find, because she pays 'em all in kind. Corinna wakes, a dreadful sight. Behold the ruins of the night. A wicked rat her plaster stole, half eat, and dragged it to his hole. The crystal eye, alas, was missed, and puss had on her plumpers pissed. Her pigeon picked her issue peas, and shock her tresses filled with fleas. The nymph, though, in this mangled plight, must every morn her limbs unite. But how shall I describe her arts to recollect the scattered parts? Or show the anguish, toil, and pain of gathering up herself again? The bashful muse will never bear in such a scene to interfere. Corinna in the morning dizened, who sees will spew, who smells be poisoned.